This is John Locke, and today I'm answering a question. What do you do if in Google Search Console you have a lot of impressions for certain search phrases, but you're not getting a lot of click-throughs? For those who don't know, Google Search Console, a free thing that you can sign up for. You add a little piece of code to your site or to your DNS records, and it will basically give you information on your site. And one of the things that you can look at is you can track the impressions, which is how many times people saw your search result for a given search phrase. If they scrolled to it and saw it, that's an impression. If they click on it, obviously that's a click, but you can look at other things as well in there, such as average position that you were at for that query, meaning what is the average position in Google search results that you were at, and you can get the click-through rate, the actual percentage of the click-through rate. So what I would be looking at, if you're getting a lot of impressions for a cluster of search phrases, now some of them you're gonna rank higher for than others. Let's say that you have a whole cluster of search phrases that are all basically the same. People are looking for the same thing. They're just typing in different phrases to try and get to the same place. Now, if you have a lot of impressions and you have a high average search position, if the average position that you're at is high and you have a lot of impressions, there's a couple things that you can do. The first thing that I would do is rewrite your title tag. That is the headline that appears in the search results. It could be that it's not compelling enough. Maybe, be sure to add your keywords in there. Be sure to, if you're in a city, like put the city, be sure to put the keywords. Put your brand name if it can fit, but make that a compelling title that people are attracted to, that stands out a little bit from the rest of the search results. Second thing you can do is rewrite your meta description for that page. Now that is the couple of sentences that are right underneath the headline. When you look at the Google search results, there's a headline, that's the title tag, and then a couple lines of descriptive text, that is the meta description. So again, you want to write that description as if you're selling a piece of copy, words on a page that you're trying to sell the idea of what this page is going to deliver, what people are going to find. So you want to sell that as best you can with the title and meta description. Now the third thing that you can do, and this will only apply in a few cases, but you can add the appropriate schema markup to the page. Now the example that I'm going to give is, for example, if you have a e-commerce page, let's say that is a page where you're selling a product in an e-commerce store. A lot of websites have the ability to set it up to where if people leave a review, then that page will output the star rating for that page, for that product, I should say, as a star average. Now, if it is marked up correctly using schema data, aggregate rating, then what will happen is in the search results, sometimes you will see the actual star rating for that product underneath. So that is another thing that could compel people to click on that result. So to sum up the three things, rewrite your title, rewrite your meta description, add the appropriate type of schema data for that page. If it's a product, make sure that you have review star ratings to where people can review that, and it makes sure that it outputs that aggregate data. You can run it through a tool called Google Structured Data Testing Tool. And I will link that below in show notes, but if you're using any type of structured data to output stars, review rating, output that URL, copy it, put it in that structured data testing tool, and it will tell you if you have valid markup. So those are three things that you can do to improve your clicks. Remember, the idea is to beat the average click-through for your position. The higher the position on the page, the higher your click-through rate for that query should be. So the higher on the page that you are, the higher position, the more your click-through rate should ideally be. If it's not high, or if you have a lot of impressions, not a lot of clicks, do those things, rewrite it to where people feel more compelled to click on it. Hope that helps. My name is John Locke. My business is Lockdown Design and SEO. We're here every single day giving tips on SEO. That's all I have for now. Until next time, peace.